Ecamm fam, what's good, y'all? Welcome to another episode of Marshall Creates with Ecamm. So we got a good one for you today. I told you guys that I'm going to be giving you periodic updates on the new home office here in Florida. So this is the first update in that series, okay? So I actually have to do a bit of tweaking to my lighting because I'm always doing some tweaking. I'm excited about this one just to give you guys a bit of a behind the scenes look at this current setup that I'm working on, I have been working on, and will be working on for the foreseeable future. I'm excited about this one. Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Thank you. I appreciate it, Paul. Truly, if you guys didn't see the video, it's my Ecammiversary. I've been using Ecamm for just about exactly 3 years, y'all. I joined Ecamm, I believe, in February of 2020, really at the beginning of the pandemic. And here we are 3 years later, y'all, and I'm on Ecamm's channel. Who would have thunk it? And of course, you guys know I've done a lot of work with Ecamm over the past few years. So celebrate my Ecammiversary. Just when I was working on that video, if you haven't seen it, check it out. Ecammiversary, it was released yesterday, it was yesterday. It's been a busy week. Because Tuesday, a video that I did with Wix was released. So that was a big hoopla. And I used Ecamm to actually make that happen. So that was cool. A lot has been going on this week, y'all. So if you haven't seen it, definitely check out the video. Mr. Waves, I know, man. Me too. Me too, Sterling. I missed the waves. I don't know if they would have survived down here in this Florida humidity, though. So, I decided to grow my hair out in November just to have a bit of a different look. And shout out to Sterling, man. I believe I introduced you to the Ecamm fam as well. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think I did. I think I did. Katie, if this is you, hello, whoever it is, hello. Great to see you. Parker, it is good to see you. Welcome to Marsh Creates. I appreciate you guys for tuning in live. And please, if you could hit that like button, I'd appreciate it. We would all appreciate it. Yes, so Katie added the link to the stream here. If you want to check out the video. It was really cool to look back on the past few years to see how I've been using Ecamm, and I use it all the time. Of course, like daily, but just to see how I've been using it and things that have happened as a result. Even just to touch on the Wix video really quickly. So if you guys didn't see that in the video, I didn't say their name, but I showed a clip from that commercial or like ad that recently came out. But that whole process, like when we were talking through with their team, like how we were going to do it, there were a couple of different options. They were like, we could come down there. Maybe you could come up here there in New York, at least in the United States, one of their offices. But they said, you know, we prefer you for you to be in your home office. So I was like, yeah, that's no problem. So I flew back home to Maryland to film it. And Ecamm came to mind. I said, you know what? We can fire up Zoom so you guys can direct me and we can talk and things like that. And you can see I can use the virtual camera so you guys can see how the shots will look, like literally how they will look. And in Ecamm, I can go ahead and hit record in Ecamm so I can record those 4K files that they would need to create the commercial. So I did that. You know, I hit record inside of Ecamm. And the cool thing is, like I mentioned in the video, I went ahead and set the recording destination inside of Ecamm. I set that to a Dropbox folder that I sent them the link to in advance. So they had the link to the recordings folder in advance. So as I recorded to that folder from Ecamm and the files were going into that folder. Once they uploaded, you know, and we had fast internet up there, so I'm sure they uploaded within minutes, they were able to access those files and get them right away. So their minds were blown, to be honest, to get those files and not have to worry about sending me a link to add the files to afterwards and worry about, you know, if they were going to get them. And it was several hours, y'all, of filming. And, you know, like I mentioned in the post I put up, you know, it was mostly just me just saying the same lines over and over in different inflections and stuff like that, just so they can have a bit of a variety. And then they chopped everything together and edited the video up. And it came out great. Funny thing is, a lot of those features I was talking about in that video, I had never even seen or used yet until I got the script. So it's funny. People are like, oh, I got to check those features out. I'm like, oh, me too. I do as well. So I literally was an actor for that, even though I do use Wix for my clients, my design clients. But some of those features I was new to. They were new to me. But that was a cool experience where Ecamm played a big part in making that happen like it happened. So like I said, they were like, what is this software? What are you doing? So I put them all on to Ecamm. So hopefully they're using Ecamm over there now. It was cool because at least two of the three people that were on the Zoom with me, they're based in Tel Aviv in Israel. So that was cool as well to just have this international production going on with Ecamm at the center of it. So that was a really cool experience for me and for them. So shout out to Ecamm for making that happen, making that possible. So I don't want to get too far into the weeds, but it's been a busy week. It's been fun. Yes, sir. Yep. I thought so, Sterling. You guys got to check out Sterling's channel and his setup, because it looks amazing. It's been cool to see your progress, my brother, over the past couple of years, getting your setup together. I think you got a little Grogu in the background on your bookshelf like I had in Maryland. So yeah, shout out to you, my brother. Yes, if you guys get the like button, I'd appreciate that. Yes. So this episode, I'm gonna be showing you the office, as you can see behind me right here. This is the actual look of my stream, my recordings, at least right now. It'll be changing, of course, but I think I like it the way it is. So I just want to give you guys a bit of a preview. So let me see if this video exported. So what I did was I recorded some footage of the office, different things, so I could kind of walk through it and talk through it with you guys. Just so you can have a better view of this. I don't have the Keith Peltzer situation where I have a ton of different cameras, at least not yet. So we got to do it this way. So just bear with me, but I think it'll be cool. So let me just make sure this is exported completely. Just check my files and then I'll share my screen with you guys and kind of walk through things. And I'll, if you have any questions about anything that I have here, let me know. Okay, we have the video. I'll open it up, put it on this screen here, and I'm going to share my screen here. But thank you guys for tuning in today as well. Okay. Boom. Alrighty. So let me make this a bit larger. You can see my little quick iMovie edit. Let me close iMovie, as a matter of fact, because I don't need it. I usually use Final Cut, but for this, I was just chopping up cell phone video. Cool. All right, guys, I'm just going to kind of play through it, all right, and kind of talk through everything that we have going on here, all right? So like Mr. Moderator said, if you have any questions, drop that Q with the colon, and that'll help me find your questions. I appreciate it. Cool. So this is the overall look of it, y'all. So when I first... started moving things into here on this left-hand side, like I had these wood panels on this left-hand side. So I guess we can kind of start there with the wood panels. So these wood panels are from a place called Wood Veneer Hub. So I actually got them when I was moving around down here in Florida. Now I can't find my mouse when I need it. Okay, hold on. There we go. So when I was moving around from Airbnb to Airbnb, like down here in Florida, we came in November and we were at this place called Villatel. Really nice place. We were there for a couple months. But of course, work still goes on, right? So I had to find a way to try to have a consistent look and feel. So I was like, you know what? Let me get these portable, not necessarily portable, but these wood panels from Wood Veneer Hub and set them up behind me. So as we do move around or whatever, wherever we go, I'll have these panels behind me to have a consistent look. So I think it's called Wood Veneer Hub. Let's see here. I'm going to pull it up and show it to you guys. Oh, it's thewoodveneerhub.com. Alrighty. So I'll just show it to you guys if you have any questions about that. So they have these wooden panels. They're like acoustic panels, but they look good as well. So they're really built for sound absorption. And as you can see, people use them in a variety of different ways. So I just have these right here. And I got four of these boxes. So like each one comes in, it's like actually half of this. Like each box, it says 25.2 inches, but it's actually half, and it's two of those to make up these dimensions that come in each box. So I got four of them. It's actually more than I need right now, but this is what they look like. And you can actually stain them and install them like on the wall. I've seen other people use them, and they cut around like outlets and things like that. But I literally have them sitting on the floor, guys. Like, as you can see right here, I literally have them sitting on the floor, leaned up against the wall, because we are renting in this spot that we're at down here in Florida. So I don't want to drill into the wall too much or anything like that. So as of right now, for the purpose of, you know, the content creation and things like that that I need to do, like, you can't tell from this shot that they're just sitting on the floor. So it works for now, you know. So I may not stain them. I think I'm kind of cool. I'm getting used to this look. So I likely won't stain them, and I likely won't like drill them to the wall or anything like that. I was thinking about having some sort of let me mute this. Thinking about having some sort of like wall that moves, like maybe with some type of board with some casters that moves that I can move around. But I haven't done that. You know, it works fine as it is right now. So that's how I have it. So you guys can see behind the scenes. It's just sitting on the floor. Let me check in with you guys. All right, cool. So I'll go back to this. Cool. Yep. So they're just sitting on the floor like that. And I did have them on this wall right here at first. So if you saw the first couple episodes, I had it like this. My wife, she had some feedback because I had this bookshelf showing like over, you know, on in front of the wooden panels. And she thought it looked kind of busy. So I had the idea to move them to the other wall and angle the desk here, as you see, angle the desk. And then have it have like a split situation. So, you know, you see the wood panels on one side, and then you see the bookshelf on the other side. Like, so it's literally split down the middle. So kind of like two different looks, right? So, yeah, that's what we have going on right now. Functionality wise, it's cool. I like it, actually. You know, I'm still facing the window, as you can see on this right hand side. I'm still facing the window so I can get some of that sunlight. But something that I have done recently is I shut the blinds. Like the first few episodes, you may notice that the lighting is different. And that's what's cool about this stuff, y'all. You can always experiment. So looking back, I'm like, man, that's too bright. I think I got a little too excited about having a window for a change in my office. But looking back at those shots, I'm like, I wish I would have controlled that light a bit more. So just closing the blinds. I can open them back up when I'm off not streaming and I'm not recording. Close the blinds just to control some of the light. I don't even really need curtains in here. I may do it for aesthetic reasons, but having the blinds closed like this, it really helps with the overall look because I'm able to control the light. And that's something I talked about in the lighting video. So I'm actually practicing what I preach for a change. So controlling the light has been key, at least to, I think I like this look a lot better than when I had the light, when I had the window wide open. So we got a question coming in from Tessie. What are you using as an audio interface? And is there any audio processing? Yes. So I do use the DBX 286S processor and a Scarlett 2i2. And there is a bit of processing going on this DBX. I'll have to show you exactly like what the settings are on there, but I will get to that shortly and show you that shortly in this video. So I appreciate the question. So yeah, let's move on. So yeah, so this is the office as it is right now. So this is what the office was. This is what it looked like before moving some stuff in. So the thing is, man, we had to get everything brand new because coming from Maryland, we really came down here on vacation, and we ended up kind of staying Even though we kind of flirted with moving down here a lot. So that was always kind of in the back of our mind. Like, what if we just stay down here? With that said, like, all of our stuff, like, all of my stuff is in Maryland still. Like, my everything in that office. The good thing is that when we do go back, you know, during hurricane season, that's the plan right now, I can just plop down in that office and continue on, like, doing what I do from a content creation standpoint, work standpoint there. So, but that it presents its unique challenges in that I'm starting from scratch down here. So that's why it doesn't look like much now. Like, I don't have, like, a drawer that I'm looking for that I need. I don't have, like, any artwork, anything like that. So, but we're making do, right? So the good thing is I've been able to kind of get the essentials that I need within the past month or so. So I got a desk here, which I'll show you guys a bit more shortly. So just to give you, I guess to skip ahead a bit. So this is a flexi spot standing desk, and it was about $250. So I'm satisfied with it. The only thing is I wish it was a bit wider. Wish it was a bit wider. So it's a little more smaller than I'm used to. And I wish it really was an L-shaped desk. So this carpet here that you see is from rugs.com. Got this from rugs.com. It was about $200, and it's a 9 by 11, I believe. No, it's actually an 8 by 10. It's 8 by 10. So let me check in with the comments. Okay. So as you can see, I have my 4-year-old. He just turned 4. Let me go back. I have a little station for him to chill, like a little chill station over here that he could chill at. He has a little recliner that we got him. So when he's a handful, he's like really rowdy. I have 4 kids total, but my youngest, he is a handful. So if my wife needs a break, or he just wants to come and chill, he could come over there and just chill out, watch this little Disney Plus shows and stuff like that. And you know, so he chills over there. Got a little camera set up in case I'm not in here and he still wants to come in here and chill. I can keep an eye on him. So just a heads up, you guys probably saw it a few seconds ago. My cable management at this point is pretty much non-existent. All right, so don't judge me. Do not judge me, because it's still a work in progress. Once I get everything I need, you know, and it's a lot of stuff that I'm going to be moving around, I'll work on the cables. And it's a bit different because typically you'll have your desks up against the wall, right? In most cases. So the cable management isn't as horrendous, or you can't really tell. Like, when people do their office tours and stuff, they may show you a little bit of their cable management. But mine, and I'm getting new things in, like, on a daily basis, and I'm changing things up. This is what we're working with, y'all. So do not judge me when you see this bird's nest of a cable system, or lack thereof. All right. So this is so as you can see right here, the cables are crazy. They're crazy. So this is the backside. I have a little shelf over here. I'm just going to let this play through. So this is kind of how I have the camera set up on this this extension pole here. Forget the brand, but I can look it up. If you guys have any questions specifically about, like, the names of these products, let me know. And I have this little tablet stand. I literally just got in a few days ago because I had it on more of a traditional arm, almost like a Visa arm. The little Eero over here, a light bulb. So this is the back of the DBX 286 processor, a hard drive. So I have my Ethernet going into that. It's going into this anchor hub here, and also have this other anchor hub I'm not currently using, but I'm going to set it up soon. Doc Rock actually sent me that a couple years ago. my G-Book, Cam Link, a couple hard drives down there. So this is the Canon R6 camera that I'm currently using. So these are the mini hard drives, the SSDs that I edit off of. Down here, this is a power bank. Let's have, like, a little monitor shelf as well. So this is the view from behind the desk. So this is just a little little shelving unit that I got just to have. I was actually going to put like the processor. I had the processor, the DBX on there, some other stuff, but I ended up moving it. Ended up moving it and just putting it on the desk. So that's why it's kind of over there, just for like miscellaneous stuff. I have my Parrot Padcaster teleprompter up here at the top. So you guys know I've used that. I've talked about this quite a bit. It's on my full office tour video. So I'll stick my cell phone in there and use that as a teleprompter when I need to. So on this side, I have the, oh, it cuts to Jace. So I'll bring it back. I'll show you guys that on the other side. But that was a Anchor Power Extend. I really like Anchor. So this is the laptop stand that I have. I don't know the brand, but I can get it if you guys want to know what it is. But all this stuff was relatively inexpensive, y'all. I'm talking like $20 or less, you know, maybe $30 or less. A lot of this stuff that I got more recently. So this monitor, I don't know the name of the brand. I just looked it up on Amazon. But I've had it for a couple years. They still sell it. It's $159. But it's a nice, it's a 15.6 inch. It's HD monitor. And it comes with actually like a sleeve, almost like those iPad folios. But I took it off so I can stick it on this. But that's how I've been using it for a while. So this is the other side of the desk. So I have the Elgato, I believe it's the Wave Arm. And it works. It works pretty well. And underneath I have this headphone holder that I stuck under there. And it has like two sections right here. So you can have two headphones on there as well. So this is like a little mini trash can. So I'm going for like more of like a white and wood combination here. I'm not really doing the RGB, so you likely won't see me with the color lights down here just because I probably overdosed on RGB lighting down up in Maryland. So I'm going for more of a fresh vibe. So this is the bookshelf, okay? With this light, and I'll show you how that works in a minute. And let me pull up my Amazon order history. So this is a fake plant that I got as well. Little Manfrotto tripod. So I was using this Manfrotto for a while because I had like an extra shelf. I had a shelf behind my computer. So this thing here, so you saw the AirPods Maxes, and if you've seen any of my other videos where I talk about it, I'm not really a huge fan of the AirPods. I mean, I like them to have as like a kind of like a collector's item because it's a nice piece of hardware to me. But sound quality wise, I like the Sony 1000XM4s a lot better. So I was like, you know what? Not to say it's a paperweight because I have to use it from time to time. My son uses them when he's doing homeschool sometimes. But I was like, yeah, I'm going to just put them on the bookshelf because I don't have a lot going on the bookshelf. So I actually got this from Etsy. So I don't know if you guys have AirPods Maxes, but I got them off Etsy. Let me go there so I can show it to you guys. Purchases. Okay, so this is it right here. So it's just 3D printed. And it has like the little magnets in it, so they can make sure that the AirPods are powered off. So you can see that they're only $23.99 by limit 3D printing. That's cool. I don't know if the 3D is supposed to be like limited, a different play on limited, if so, that's dope. Yeah, so I like it. I think it's cool to display the AirPods Maxes. So that's okay. So now, oh yeah, so that's just like a little protective covering that I ordered for my headphones. So this bookshelf actually has like a light on each level to illuminate whatever is on the bookshelf. And you can change it up to like a different color temperature. You can turn it off, of course. So you can see the different color temperatures. Like, of course, I like to keep it on a more of a warmer color temperature. And then this light is just a standing light. Let me find the name of it for you guys that I have in the corner. So this is what kind of gives a glow on this shot behind me. So you know what? Let me show you that. So this is the, this is it right here. Edishine Modern Corner LED Floor Lamp. So $62.99. It's inexpensive. It's not RGB though, guys. It's just, you know, has the warm and the bright color temperatures, right? The cool and the warm color temperatures. So, but this is it right here. But I'll show you what it looks like. I'll actually change them up and show you, you guys, what color temperatures look like, what the color temperatures look like. So let me go to Ecamm. Okay, come back here. So I it comes with this remote, right? So if I turn it off, so this is what it, this is what it off. You can see the light up here on the bookshelf. If I turn it back on, boom. And then if I change the color temperature, you know, I think that's the brightness. Hold on. I hit the snowflake. Yeah, there we go. So did, can you, could you tell that that changed? Yeah, you can tell that the color temperature is changing, right? See? So if I go back, make it more warm. Boom. See, I like it like that. As opposed to this. Either way, it looks cool, I think, but I like it warm. I like it warm, y'all. Camera. Hey, Kathy. I actually answered your, I believe you were the one that asked the question on the other video. But I use a Canon R6. I use a Canon R6 and a Sigma 24 millimeter lens. That's what I use. So yes, that is what I use. So yeah, this is the, these are the lights that I have, and I'll show you how I have it mounted on the bookshelf in a second. Let me just make sure. Zoom and pan before you lose audio quality. Bruh, you know that is not related to this stream. You my guy, so I can get on you like that. Completely unrelated, but let's find out. Let's find out. So I'm gonna zoom in. Well, it's only allows me to zoom in this much, 50. So let's see. I think it still looks good. What do you think? What do you think? I'm gonna do the rest of the stream like this. I guess it depends on your camera as well, Sterling. What you have it set at, like if you have a 4K camera, if you have it set to 4K in your camera and then set to 4K inside of Ecamm, and then whatever platform you're streaming to, if that even accepts 4K, you know, it's a plethora of factors. But I think it looks good. I think it looks good. I think it looks good. So yeah, you could try that with yours as well on your end. To see how it will look for your camera, Sterling. Alrighty. So let's jump back over here. Okay. Okay, so this is how I have it mounted. So I actually didn't screw it into the bottom piece, and I have this cable tie here. Tying it to the pole. It's literally a cable tie you get off Amazon. Like a pack of 1,000 for like $7. I have it up here. And then one at the bottom as well. So I have it, just have a cable tie at the bottom to kind of hold it in place. And I don't have it screwed into like the circular disc that comes with it. So at the bottom of this shelf, I just have miscellaneous stuff that I don't have really have a place for it yet. A couple books, as you can see, my bookshelf is pretty bare because, you know, we came here with nothing. Even though I will say I did bring my books, five of my best books, y'all. My favorite books, my top books for graphic designers. I brought them with me because I still plan on doing a video on that, and I wanted to have the books on hand. So that's what, you know, I have that. And then some coaching books as well, since I've been doing a bit more coaching. So I want to make sure I know what the heck I'm doing, y'all. So I'm realizing that, you know, not everybody's story and everybody's journey is the same. So what worked for me may not work for someone else. So I want to make sure I'm asking the right questions when I coach designers. So I'm just pointing out my top five books for designers right now. So we had Pocketful of Dough by Chris Doe, The Win Without Pitching Manifesto by Blair Enns, Oversubscribed by Daniel Priestley, Creative Strategy in the Business of Design by Douglas Davis, and then Burn Your Portfolio by Michael Janda. Those five are my favorite, or my top five books for graphic designers, and the other ones are kind of just mixed in there. Fake Plant looks real. Think it looks good on camera as well. And it's some, like, it comes with like some sand and then some rocks, but I've forgotten, like, you literally have to stick the as you can see right here, stick this part into some foam, right, and then pour the sand in there and then pour the rocks on top. But I moved this thing around forgetting that everything's not in place, and the rocks have just went flying, so I had to clean it up. It happened twice. I'm like, oh my gosh. So it's a hat with my logo for my high value designer system, and there's this fake plant that I got. I think it was less than $100. It's some type of palm. But if you guys want to know what type, like the exact product, then let me know. I can just go to my Amazon order history. And I have this little riser as well. I would like to get like a white pot. Which I just haven't done it yet, because this is just a little plastic one that comes with it. When I look at the planters, they're like $50. And I'm like, I only paid like 70 for the plant. I'm not about to pay $50 for a planter, at least not right now. So a little white desk. This is literally, it's like a little table, the same one that I have in Maryland. I ordered it again. And then these, you know, it's just my Bible, my notebook where I write my findings and notes down from when I do my Bible study and devotion in the mornings, and then my daily devotional book right here. So that lives right there. A little lamp and the Anchor Power Extend. I love this. I've been using it for years. I talked about it in my office tour video. Really all Anchor products, like as you can see, this Anchor thing here. When it comes to power related things and even dongles and stuff, I just go with Anchor because they remind me of Apple for some reason. Like, their stuff is always high quality. It never breaks on me. I'm never wondering, is it going to work? Is it going to fail? It always just works. So I highly recommend Anchor. I probably have to get them to sponsor one of my videos or something at some point, because I use a lot of their stuff, y'all. So as you can see, the settings for the desk there, the height settings, I don't even stand up as much as I probably should, but this is the Elgato, what's the name of this? Somebody help me out. The Elgato something. Hold up, why am I having a brain fart right now? Hold up, I'm gonna find a name for you guys. Elgato Light. Key Light Air, that's right. Elgato Key Light Air. So I like this light. It actually gets pretty bright. I had like a bootleg version of it that I used when we first came down here, and I didn't like it. It didn't get bright enough. But I could just control it through the app and everything, and it works great. So this is like a little, 3-in-1 power charger situation for my phone. You know, I have the MagSafe and then the Apple Watch and the AirPods. As you can see, the, DBX 286 processor is down here. So, I mean, you could kind of see the settings that I have it, but my best recommendation would be, one, well, look at a tutorial video where you set yours up if you end up getting this, and then two, tweak it to your liking, you know, because there may be certain factors in your environment where you may have a certain amount of background noise, and then you may have certain preferences for your own sound. So the best way to figure out what's best is to just listen to it yourself. When you get it and you tweak it, but stuff is pretty cool. Like, once you set it up and get your sound, you pretty much don't have to touch it. You pretty much don't have to touch it at that point. So this is the desk overall. See, I have the iPad Pro 11 the smaller one. I don't remember the exact size of it. The smaller iPad Pro with the keyboard, have a little D-brand. This is not D-brand. This is something else, but I have a D-brand skin on the keyboard of my my MacBook. So it's a 14-inch MacBook Pro, M1 Pro, and I love it. This is just like a U-green little iPad or tablet holder. So sometimes I'll use this and don't have the keyboard on my desk, like the MacBook Pro Magic Keyboard. I'm not the MacBook Pro, the iPad Pro Magic Keyboard. But I primarily use the iPad Pro for like YouTube and the Endo app I talked about a couple episodes ago. I'll usually have it up on here and then have my headphones on, my AirPods on, and I primarily use it for that and YouTube. I was using it for writing, you know, writing scripts and stuff, but as of now, like, I just do that on the MacBook, since that's like my primary device. So this is the MacBook Pro. This is the D-brand skin that I have on the keypad, on the trackpad, and I also have like a silicone protector on the keyboard. As you can see, I have the monitor here, so it can be a second monitor. That's the one I'm looking into right now. So I have the video playing on it. So it works really seamlessly. And I have it just connected via HDMI into the dongle as well. So, and this is a felt desk pad by Eros. But honestly, I wouldn't get it, so I'm going to skip past this. I'm going to have to get one. I'm going to have to get a Grove Made one. I was trying to cheap out on the desk pad, but this thing still hasn't fully flattened, and it's annoying. And it's the material of it. It doesn't really feel felt. It feels like a bit smoother than I would like. So, yeah, you can see the rest of the settings on the DBX-286 right here that I have. So this is, you know, what allows me to achieve this sound right now. So these are how I have my settings. Hopefully it sounds good. And we're finishing up, y'all. So it's my hat. Okay, last but not least, we have the Hayworth Fern office chair. I love this chair. If you subscribe to me on my main channel, you know I love this chair. I did a review. Actually, did two, because I did an updated review for like a long-term review, since I had the chair almost 3 years now. I love this. It's an ergonomic office chair. It is not cheap, though, y'all. It's pretty expensive, but you know, when it comes to sitting down like all day, every day, you just at least want to have something that feels good, and it's good for your back and ergonomic. So as you can see, the curve right here, it really fits nicely in your back. And they also have another version that has even more additional lumbar support in here in this spine area. But yeah, if you want to grab one, let me know, and I can send you my affiliate code. But yeah, it's a nice chair, y'all. They are kind of expensive, but they're in line with the Herman Miller Aeron, which I think this looks way better than the Aeron. The Aeron is ugly. It's no way around that, but I know it's like the industry standard. And it probably feels amazing, but it's ugly. And as a designer, it just wouldn't work for me just off of that alone. but they also have the Herman Miller Embody as well, and that's actually what I was looking into before I got this, and I started seeing ads for the Fern. So I got I was like, oh, that's it, that's the one. So I went and sat in it at a dealer in Maryland, and then I ordered one there. So this one they actually sent to me down here, so I didn't have to pay for this one, but you know, they made a lot of money off of me, so they were willing to send me the Fern, a free Fern. So I paid for one, and they sent me a free one as well. So this is the free one, y'all, and I love it. It's great. And that's pretty much it, y'all. That is the office tour update. I guess it's not a whole full tour, but it's an update on how things are coming along so far down here in the sunny state of Florida. So let me just check back in with y'all to see what I may have missed. Obs, what is good? What is good? Good to see you. Good to see you. Kila Air, yes, thank you for that. I don't know why. Oops. I don't know why I had a brain fart there. let me switch back to the other scene. That audio interface. How would the audio interface perform over the Rodecaster Pro? You know what? I do not know that because I have never used the Rodecaster Pro. But the Rodecaster Pro, you know, I know a lot of people have that and use it and like it. I think Doc even has it. But I've never really had an interest in getting that because this worked well for me. But I may pick it up. I may pick it up because, you know, I have some ideas, being as though I'm literally 30 minutes away from my guy, Licio, to have him join me on at least one of these episodes, or maybe just do something collaboratively. So I'm like, I may need something like that with more input so I could control the sound individually and things like that. I don't even know everything is capable of, but I may end up getting it for something like that. But it's just been me solo dolo, you know, so I haven't really used it. I don't really do a bunch of sound effects on my videos. So, I haven't picked one up. Cool. Oh, I've seen that. I've seen it. I've saved that. So, Glenessa is talking about the Journey desk pad. I've seen the ads for it. I was going to pull the trigger on it last week, or was it this week? But I didn't. I didn't do it yet. I ended up looking at the Grovemade, and I'm a Grovemade affiliate too. So I ended up looking at another Grovemade desk pad, and I was going to order one that actually matches this chair perfectly. It's like an orange version. But it was sold out. So I was like, that's a sign from God that I need to hold off on the desk pad. I already have a desk pad. It's working fine. It isn't the best, but it's not a priority right now. All right. So I'm trying to be different down here in Florida, y'all. You know, we have gas, right? The gear acquisition syndrome. I'm not trying to go off like I did in Maryland. I'm trying to do things a bit more budget conscious. So I didn't get the Journey. I think it's about 130, right, for that. But it does look nice, and it has a little charger on the side. I'm like, I have this perfectly fine charger, 3-in-1 charger right here. I don't want to spend $130 just to be able to sit my phone on the desk and charge, as opposed to sitting at an angle, which I prefer, you know, with this $30 3-in-1 charger. You know, even though I will admit that the Apple Watch part of it, it's a little funky. The connection isn't the greatest because my Apple Watch, it just makes a sound from time to time, like the charging has restarted. I'm like, what happened? But yeah, I'm not going to do that right now, but I have seen that. I'm glad you like that. Let's see. Hayworth Zodi, yes, shout out. Look, you in the Hayworth family, let's go. Yeah, I've looked at their other chairs as well for my wife, because she won't need anything as fancy as the Fern. I wouldn't even want anything as fancy as the Fern. But yeah, their office chairs are really dope. David, what's good, my brother? We are just wrapping up here, man. So if you guys have just joined us, make sure that you go back and you check out the rest of the video. So you can see the key light air here. I probably have it a bit too close because I don't really want it in the shot, so I can adjust it or just move it back. But I like it up here, like at this angle. So this looks cool, and I can adjust it. I can adjust the intensity and the brightness inside of the app. So if I turn it off, you see, boom, it's a little too dark for me. Turn it on, and then it adjusts. Boom, that works. Okay. Control spending. Boom, that's what it is. That's what it is. Yep. You have a Grovemade discount? Yes, I do. I do have a Grovemade discount. Yes, if you go to my channel and go to the Hayworth Fern 2-year review, it is right in there. It's right in that description. I don't want to just be giving it out willy-nilly on this channel. I don't want to cross-pollinate like that. You know what I'm saying? Next thing you know, I'll be like, what happened to Marshall? He had a weekly show on Ecamm. I don't know what happened to him. He was a nice guy. Katie probably wouldn't mind, but yeah, it's right on my Fern 2-year review video. The discount code is in there if you want to get something from Grovemade. But yeah, that stuff is really good. So the light right behind me, it is, I'll show you guys this again. Let me just make sure I'm not missing anything else. Key light over the softbox. No, I actually like the softbox. It's a bit of more of a softer look to me. But when they're paired together, and it was like this in my office in Maryland, they're fine. You know, they're fine. Like one main softbox is more of a softer, bright light. And then a light like this, because in Maryland, it had a similar setup. It wasn't a Key Light Air, but it was like a newer bicolor 480 or something like that. And it would work similarly to this. So, but yeah, one is a Key Light, one is a fill light, even though this is called a Key Light, but I use it as, I guess, a fill light. They both kind of, I guess, the same type of brightness and intensity, but typically, you know, you would have one like the brightness turned down a bit on one of them to kind of add more depth to your face. But I have both of mine kind of, I like a more even lighting on my face. So that's just a preference that I have. But yeah, let me show you the light. Close out of this video and show you guys the light. And I could just show you my Amazon account, honestly, because I got a lot of stuff. All right, let me bring this over here. So this is the light, Glenessa, right here. Edshine Modern Corner LED Floor Lamp. So it comes in three different colors. I just got the silver because it was the cheapest at the time. It still is. It comes in black and then gold and then silver. Like, people ain't going to see. They're not going to see the color of the light. So I just got the cheapest one they had, y'all. So let's see what else we got in here. Okay. Orders. Go back down to. Okay, yeah, just got this. So that's coming today. Because the way I have everything positioned, I'm not going to say my feet are swinging, but they're a little higher than they need to be. You know what I'm saying? Because the desk, this flexi spot desk, doesn't get as low as I would like it to. But it's fine. You know, just get something like this. I still save about $1,000, you know, compared to getting something else. So I'm actually going to be switching the plant that I have right here, switching this up with this, and I'm going to put this one downstairs. So I think it looks fine overall, but I think I want something a little more subtle. I feel like this is a lot going on right here on this side. Tell me let me know what y'all think, though, y'all. I mean, you think I should keep it and then put this one downstairs? What? I think I may like this a little better on this side. So, but as you can see, it was only $56. Cheap. So got these just for my pens. It's like a little silicone thing right here, like a little squishy. But it works for my pens and stuff, so my pens aren't just sitting here. So this is the stand right here for the monitor. Some miscellaneous. So I was using this for a couple of days for the monitor. But now it's on that bottom shelf. I actually like the stand better. Light bulbs. I actually put this light bulb back there, but it was so bright you couldn't see anything. you couldn't see any of the detail. It was just a big old bright bulb back there. Probably because I have on this this Tiffin Black Pro Mist to add a bit more of like a brightness, a glow to the light. So if we take it off, let's take it off and see what happens. Boom, you see that? Can you tell the difference? It's not as atmospheric. It's not as much of a glow or a haze, right? So yeah, so when I had this light sitting back there on that shelf, it was just blown out. I can't change the brightness of it. So yeah, put that back on there. There we go. Cool, let's check in here. Oh, no doubt, my brother. Thank you. Thank you for tuning in. Awesome, awesome. Under cabinet light. So this is actually, let me show you guys this. This is a bookshelf. Let me come back here. It's built into the bookshelf. So let me find it. This is one of the first things I got when we moved in here. So this is the monitor stand, y'all. If you're wondering, this is the monitor stand that I got. Less than $100. And you see those monitor stands out here, like $200. So, let me see here. This is the trash can, if anybody's wondering. $36. Planter. I got these planters and they're just huge. So I was like, you know what? They're in the garage. I'll just say that. The bookshelf. So here it is right here. So it has the light built in to each level. Thing is, I don't have, you know, see that crossbar back there, like that X crossbar. I took that off. It's probably there for stability, but I took that off because it didn't look good to me, like in the camera. So hopefully we don't have any earthquakes, anything crazy happening, where, you know, the joint would just fold and fall down. But yeah, this is it right here. And it has a $10 coupon. Cool. So hopefully that helps. Oh, where was this? I must have missed it. I'm sorry. Okay. Cool. But yeah, let me know if you guys have any other questions. So just to kind of recap, we're about, what, 2 months in to this new office. So I think it looks pretty cool. You know, my bookshelf is still pretty bare. So I am going to go home and grab some stuff, you know, that'll kind of help. And, you know, Doc sent me this really cool wooden thing with my logo on it. Like, actually, this logo right here, it's like my personal brand. It's an M right here at the top, but it, like, overall, it's like a fox silhouette or, like, icon situation. So I have that. Doc sent me that when he was doing woodworking a couple years ago, and I have that in the office in Maryland. I want to grab that. I want to grab my lighted sign. Shout out to Alicio for that, and some more books and just some stuff to kind of fill out the bookshelf, and just some other things that I need. Like, I'm working with this right now, but I have a monitor up there that's not being used, so I want to bring that down here. So there's quite a bit of things that I want to get. But overall, I want to keep it minimal, y'all. Like, I don't want to do the most down here like I did in Maryland. Like, if you've heard me talk about it, the journey was fun. Setting up that office, it was a lot of fun. But once it was done, I was like, okay, what next? Now what? What do I do now? I mean, I did my office tour video that I've been dreaming of doing for a long time. It's out. It's getting love. But now what? Like, what's next? And I realized, like, it really didn't make me any more creative or any more inspired, anything like that. If anything, like, the process of getting there did all of that, but actually having it, I just felt, honestly, I felt like, I don't want to say I felt like I wasted a lot of money, but I was like, what is the point of this? Like, you know, I got all of this stuff, like, I'm not even really using. Like, I have 4 HomePods in that joint. 2 HomePods and like 2 minis and then a subwoofer. Barely used that. Sounded great. Sounded awesome, but didn't really use it because it, you know, can be disruptive, you know, to the daily homeschool and just daily stuff we had going on. And I've used my headphones a lot of the time, like noise canceling to block out background noise. So it's like, spent all this money doing all this stuff and I'm not even really using it. So I vowed not to do that again because I got to the perfect office, at least in my head. And then I won't say I was unsatisfied. I was like, oh, this isn't as cool as I thought on a day-to-day basis. The tour, the office tour, phenomenal. It was fun to do. You know, people loved it, found value in it, got stuff for their office. But for me personally, it's like, all right, now what? Like, so I don't want to do that down here. I want to keep it simple. I want to keep it minimal. And I really want to focus on the content, you know. So, but that's where I am, y'all. That is where I am. Check in. Cool. Vocal processing chain. Yeah, I showed you that. And I can show you again. Let me, yeah, that's it. Let me jump back to that part of the video again to show you that what I have my settings as. All right. Oops. I'm going to find it really quickly for you. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Okay, so I think I moved the... Did I put the iPad down at all? Yeah, here we go. Yeah, so this is how I have my DBX-286 set up. So if you want to take a screenshot of this... So this is how I get my sound, but like I said, it'll all depend on your own acoustic environment, like how it sounds in your office, how your voice sounds, what mic you're using. I'm using a Shure SM7B. I have thought about like getting the Logitech Blue Sona because it's nice looking. I know people that recommend it, and it have a white version, and I'm going with more of a white light theme. And they have different colored windscreens, even though I just bought a colored windscreen from the reporter store that's supposed to be coming. But I need another mic down here anyway. But yeah, this is how I have my setup. So I have my the XLR cable going into the back of the DBX-286, as you can see at the beginning of the video. And then I have this cord here going from the DBX-286 into the Scarlett. So let me see, this is the back of it right here. Excuse the mess, y'all. The the cables, I'll get them together at some point, but right now we still under construction, y'all. We are still very much under construction. So this is the XLR cable going into the DBX from the SM7B, and this is the output. It's like an audio cable. I don't know the specific name of it. TSR cable, maybe. And then it goes into the front of the Scarlett. And that's it. And then the Scarlett plugs into the computer via USB. USB-C. So, hopefully that helps. I'm not an audio whiz or anything. Yo, that's hilarious. That is hilarious. That's a comment of the of the day. But now I gotta ban you. No, I'm kidding. Look, I got the snip snip. I got a vasectomy, so but look, my kids are still young. But like I told y'all a couple weeks ago, or was it last week when we talked about productivity hacks? My youngest takes a nap while I'm on these streams. So that helps with the background noise. No, I'm not using any plugins. No, ma'am. Nope. Hardware don't fail. Not jacked by OS updates and good mics. Don't need plugins that cost more than buying a good mic. Yep, that's it. That's it. Yep. TRS to ring sleeve or for phono is a muggle name for it. Got you. Yeah. But yeah, I'm going to check out the Blue Sona. Y'all may see me pop up with a new mic one of these days. I'm not blue. It's Logitech. Oh, we at 302, y'all. I got a dip. But yeah, hopefully this was helpful for you guys. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Yeah, and I'll be sure to answer them as soon as I can. All right. If we don't have any other questions, I will get out of here. Please hit that like button before you dip. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed already, and join the Ecamm fam if you aren't in the Ecamm fam already. All right, I'll catch you guys next week. Peace.